So you want to record a video conversation that you're having over the internet. Maybe it's for a video podcast or you just decided to interview someone. Either way, I'm going to show you a pretty cool OBS setup for that. We are going to use the Move Transition plugin by Xeldral just to make everything look smoother. So let's get right into it. So here we are in OBS Studio. I created a brand new scene collection called Podcast, and I'm going to start by creating my scenes. So bottom left, we're going to go down and we're going to click the plus to create one scene. We're going to need 5 scenes in total, I believe. First scene, I'm going to call this both. So basically that's going to be the scene where we're going to see both us and our guest. Second scene is going to be guest alone. Third scene will be me alone. Then we'll create 2 additional scenes for guest camera and me camera. And basically the guest and me camera are scenes that are dedicated for specific cameras. For example, if you were capturing the guest via Discord, I would go full screen here. Then I would alt tab back into OBS, click plus under the source list and go with window capture. This would be the guest cam, click okay, and then select Discord. From there, what you can do is hold alt and drag the sides to crop it, and then you'll be able to full screen it. Like this. And if I right click, transform, fit the screen a little bit more just to make sure we don't have any borders. And this is how you would get your guest cam inside of the specific scene. And for the me camera scene, you can either add your video capture device or also capture your own camera from Discord, but that would be redundant. Just as an example, and to avoid confusion, I'm going to be playing videos on those scenes so that we can really see the difference. So this will represent my guest and this will represent me. All right, in order for this specific setup to work, we actually need both of those scenes within the same scene at all times. So I'm gonna click plus, I'm gonna go to scene, and I'm gonna pick me camera and then guest camera. Scene, guest camera. Now what I'm gonna do is click on guest camera, hold shift, click on me camera to have both selected. I'm gonna right click and click copy. I'm gonna go to the guest alone scene. I'm gonna right click and I'm gonna paste a reference. I'm gonna do the same thing for the me alone scene. So as you can see, we have those 2 sources in every scene, in every main scene at least. Now I can start formatting. In this case, we would want the guest to be on the side like this. I can hold alt in order to crop. Then I can select the me camera, move it. And there we go. We have a quote unquote podcast going on. If we want to crop this, we can also do this in order to create some sort of bar in the middle, but that's not necessary. Okay. So now remembering that the guest is going to be on the right and we are going to be on the left, we're going to go to guest alone. We're going to turn off the guest camera and we're actually going to move the me camera all the way to the left. Try to keep it straight. Turn back the guest camera. Now that's what this scene is like. For the me alone camera, you guessed it. We're gonna select the guest camera and we're going to bring it all the way to the right. Try not to move on the vertical line. There we go. And it should look like this. And just like that. Boom, boom, boom. All right, those are your 3 scenes. Now here are the 2 main principles of this setup. First of all, you will be setting up keyboard shortcuts in order to switch between the scenes, meaning that while you're having the interview, while you're recording, you can immediately switch to whoever is talking, saving you a lot of time in editing. The second principle of this setup is if you do not want jump cuts like this, if this is a little too brutal and you would like for it to look a little more professional, this is where the Move Transition plugin comes into place. If you installed the plugin correctly, under Scenes Transitions, you can click to add a new transition and you'll be able to pick Move. Call it Move, click OK. And here you have all the settings. You can scroll down and preview the transition. And this is what it does. Click OK. And then you'll have the duration option and you can put whatever you want, basically how much time it's gonna take between the scenes to transition. I'm gonna keep it at 1 second, so 1000 milliseconds, just for this example. And now when we switch between scenes, this is what's gonna happen. So if you're talking and your guest suddenly reacts, boom, we're gonna have the reaction here. And if you wanna have both, this is what's gonna happen. Like this, both, you alone, just like this, guest alone, and there we go. So you can tweak it however you like, but also remember that you can also have a transition override. So if you want to have a different length of the transition for specific scenes, you can also have that right there, and you can see the length is right there. Anyways, that's the main idea. Of course, you can perfect it. You can add some rounded borders. You can add whatever effect you want. You can add your lower thirds in order to show the guest and the host names. But this is, in essence, the main principle that I wanted to show, the main setup for a video podcast. That can work whether you're on Discord, Zoom, Google Meet, whatever it is. Remember to use keyboard shortcuts to switch between scenes. I personally use an Elgato Stream Deck. And you know what? If you're sitting at the desk, you might as well just click on them too. That also works. If it is a video podcast and you actually manage to switch the scenes correctly while recording, you actually don't need to edit really. And there it is. That was a quick tutorial on how to set up a video podcast or interview via OBS Studio using the Move Transition plugin. In case you didn't know, I actually have a podcast and I will have to basically remake my whole setup. If you would like to see that, basically a longer video where I go step by step over all the things I'm going to be adding, let me know in the comment section below. Other than that, you should definitely be following me on Twitch, even though I haven't been streaming a lot lately. And I will see you next time. Go out there, make me proud, a guy level, out.